This is an expected result that has some bearing on gameplay breeding practice. For example, if a cocker wants to use two cocks on a pen of hens by switching cocks every day or two in the hope that the cock producing the stronger sperm will prevail, he will be disappointed because the latest mating will determine which cock fertilizes the eggs. Also, if the cockers want to use two different cocks single mated to the same hen, it is probably not necessary to isolate the hen for weeks in order to clean her out. Normally, the next eggs fertilized after changing cocks will be fertilized by the newly introduced cocks. Of course, this is to some extent a matter of odds, with a highly probability that any given eggs has been fertilized by the most recent mating. One way to be 100% certain that no chicks from the old cock will appeal after a new cock is introduced would be to leave the hen with the new cock for about 2 weeks after switching cocks. But by that time, all sperm from the old cock will have expired and the average tubules will be filled with sperm from the new cocks. But in fact, there is a very small chance of fertilization by the old cock even 2 days after switching cocks. And this chance becomes negligible at 5 days and beyond. All of this assumes, of course, that the new cock is fertile. If he is not fertile, then the hen will continue to produce chicks from the old cock for about 2 weeks after the switch. In order to less the point that shortly after a cock switch, it is the new cock that fertilizes all of the eggs, I carried out several experiments using a pure white hatch hen, a pure white hatch tag, and a pure black cock. I determined how long after switching from the white tag to the black cock, all black chicks were produced. The white chicken carried the recessive white gene only. That is, they are homozygous or pure for white, which means that when mated together, they produce only white chicks. The black cock carries the dominant black gene only. That is, he is homozygous or pure for dominant black, and when he is mated to the white hen, only black chicks are produced when the hen was with the white stag. She was producing white chicks by switching to the black cock. I could detect the point at which the hen began to produce chicks from the black cock because at that point, all chicks would be black. In this experiment, I saved several dated eggs while the hen was with the white stag. Then I switched to the black cock, marking the date of the switch and then saving more eggs. Each egg was placed in the incubator immediately after it was removed from the nest. The eggs began to hatch 3 weeks later, one each day, and the color of the chicks was noted. The result was unexpected. The eggs laid before the switch produced white chicks. The first eggs laid after the switch produced a black chicks, and all later eggs also produced black chicks. When the cocks were switched again, the first eggs after reintroduction of the white cock produced a white chicks. Thus, only 24 hours after switching cocks, the new cock was the sire of the first chick, and all subsequent chicks produced after the switch. Several breeders have told me that 5 days is an adequate interval after a cock switch to ensure that the new eggs will be fertilized by the new cock based on my experiments. 1 or 2 days seems adequate in a single mating situation provided that the new cock is left the hen at all times. Remember that the hen will continue to harbor living sperm from the first cock, and that if the second cock is introduced and then removed, there is a small possibility that some of the sperm from the first cock will be released eventually from the lower level of the storage tubules. If the new cock is left with the hen, his sperm will constantly cover the earlier stored sperm and prevent its release. Rules of thumb. Number one, if the breeder decides to use only clean hens, the hen should be isolated from all males for 3 weeks. Number two, if the breeder decides to switch cock in a single mating, hens should wait 2 days after the switch before using the eggs. When switching cocks, the breeder must be certain that the new cock is fertile. Otherwise, he may continue to get chicks from the old cock while mistakenly believe that they are from the new cock. A simple way to test a cock fertility is to place him with a few hens that are known to be clean, and then to test the first 2 or 3 eggs from each hen for fertility. A good procedure is to use laying hens that have been isolated for about 3 weeks. Save 3 days eggs before introducing the cocks. Then, introduce the cock and save 3 days more of eggs. Place the labeled eggs in an incubator or under a hen after 3 days of incubation. Break the eggs or candle them and check for the live embryos. If the hen were elsewhere clean, the first egg should be clear. If the cock is fertile, the next egg should be contains embryos. In a yard mating of up to 10 hens per cock, it is advisable to wait 5 days before using eggs to be certain that the cock has mated several times with each hen. Okay. Yun po, sinasabi, pag kayo magsasalang ng bago, kailangan 2 linggo bago nyo ilagay sa karador. Kung kayo yung bago pa lang kayo magbago-umpisa. Ngayon, kung kayo naman magpapalit ng ganador sa isang inahin, mag-ano kayo ng 2 araw. Mga, kung magpapalit kayo ngayon ng pula, kung ang inahin nyo ay kunyari pula din, kung magpapalit, mag-switch kayo ng bagong ganador na ipapalit nyo sa kanya, mag-iintay kayo ng 2 araw. Similya na huyo ng nung pangalawang ipinalit nyo. Yun ang sinasabi sa genetics. Yun lang ang masasabi ko dyan, kasi sinasabi nila na inobserbahan nila na naghihintay sila ng mga 2-3 araw para makonfirm na yung bago nyong ganador na inilagay sa kanya na meron ng unang kumasta, ay maghihintay kayo ng 3 araw doon sa bagong ganador na isinalang niya para makonfirm nyo na similya niya yun. Yun ang po ang paliwanag doon. Sana marami kayong nabigyan ko kayo ng magandang tips sa pagpapalahe, kung paano pagpapalit, kung ilang araw bago kayo magpalit, o yung itlog na kukunin nyo kung sa unang ganador nyo kunuha o sa pangalawa nyo ganador na ipinalit, kung alin doon ang itlog na anak niya. Yun lang po ang mga simpleng paliwanag lang dyan. O maraming salamat po sa inyo. Ako'y papaalam na ulit. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. Maraming salamat po. Maraming salamat po sa inyo. Susunod po.